Thank you. Thank you. die, Howard. I know this is shocking, but I am Loth Noldor. It seems impossible to believe, but it's the truth. As you can see, my new body is not in good shape. I'm taking something to slow its deterioration, but the worms will have me soon. So listen carefully. Time is very short. We must stop them.
Stop whom?
Don't you remember? I think the drug I gave you was a bit much.
What drug? What are you talking about?
The drug I gave you when I took you out of the asylum. If I hadn't given it to you, you would have been gone for good by now. It was prepared by a very powerful shaman. But I think it prevents you from remembering what happened and who you really are.
This is all nonsense. I don't understand what you're talking about. You told me to come here, and I am here, in the very house of my ancestors. What is the meaning of this? Do you know that my father is lying in that tomb? Can you tell me why he killed himself in there? Why my mother never told me anything about my father? Why I remember things I've never known before? What is happening to me?
You must be calm. I am in a worse condition. I know this seems like nonsense, but it is happening. This world hides secrets that people must never learn. And we are a part of those secrets. Please, calm down and try to understand what I'm about to say to you. I've given you a special drug. You haven't lost your control, have you? So don't be afraid. The drug won't let him possess you too soon, but it won't last long. We must be quick to find the entrance to the sunken city. It is right under this town and its outlying areas.
Sunken city?
The necropolis city of a pre-human reptilian race.
What is your connection to this situation?
As you know, I went on a long journey 5 years ago. During my travels, I sought clues that would give me some insight into my own family history. I visited a lot of places, but I finally found my answers in a primitive forest village. Strangely, the village elders seemed to know me and told me some unbelievable things about my identity. They said I was born in that very village, the son of a European father and a mother they never revealed. Nobody spoke about her, though I persistently asked them. All I learned is that she disappeared from the village after giving birth to me, and it seemed from their tone that they were grateful when she left. I could learn nothing else about my father either, except that he was a civilized man. Apparently, I spent some of my childhood there, under the veil of strange practices and inhuman traditions. I faintly remember them showing and teaching me some horrifying things that fortunately I can't quite remember anymore. But one thing still clear in my mind, they were constantly telling me that my body was just a vessel and that someday I would return to them and be filled with true essence. And through my body, a god, worshipped by the natives, will be summoned. So, in a sense, I am just like you. Something that should not be.
What has happened to your body?
It is a long and bizarre story. My body was stolen from me. After I'd stayed at that disgusting village for a while, the elders sent me with a native guide to a nameless ruin in the middle of a jungle so dense it seemed like no human soul had ever set foot in it before us. When we arrived, that traitorous guide pushed me into a deep chamber. They planned this all along. He was not with me, only to guide me there. When I opened my eyes, I was in an enclosure with lavishly carved stone walls. I was tied tight and saw some masked figures sitting around me chanting something. They were not human. Try to imagine this. I was alone with things that were not human. Their constant hissings still reverberate in my ears. They gave me something that made my mind go cloudy. Then I believe I fainted. I don't know how much time passed, but when I regained consciousness, I was in total darkness. With the smell of damp earth filling my nose, I thought they had buried me alive. But soon, I understood how stupid it was to expect this kind of mercy from them. I managed to get above ground with my bare hands and tried to flee that damn jungle at once. But when I slipped and fell into a small puddle of muddy water, for a moment, I plunged into the scorching pit of madness. The reflection in the water showed that I now inhabited the body that once belonged to my guide.
Why did you take me out of the asylum?
To. As I said before, if I didn't, you would have been totally overcome by now. They were planning to eliminate you and take your body for good. But fortunately, I came just at the right time. We now have a chance. I can't make it by myself. They defeated everyone else except you. Look, I'm tired. Have to get my drug. Let's continue this conversation tomorrow.
Thank you. Thank you.
It seems you remember this place.
What is this place?
This is a connection to the Necropolis city. It was built by men, and your house was built over the city as well. But this link is too old. Most of its parts have collapsed, so we can't reach the city from here. There must be another way.
The city you mentioned earlier, is it the one the archaeologist found recently?
Yes. I checked the dig site, but no one was there. Their camp is still there, but the archaeologist has disappeared into thin air. And the entrance is blocked by huge rocks. They obviously don't want anyone to interfere.
Pre-human race?
Yes, a pre-human reptilian race. They built great cities and reigned before the first man existed. But then, their splendid cities mysteriously disappeared from the face of the earth, one by one. No documentation offers any insight about what might have happened to them. However, one of their cities is right below this place. The house that belongs to your family is also built over a connection to the city. There is an ancient cult of people named Children of Dis who aim to revive the reptilian race and their god. During medieval times, and even before, there were attempts to eliminate them several times, but every time they managed to survive. Some of your ancestors were with them.
You said somebody would take my body. Tell me more about this.
Someone from your own bloodline. To finish what they started years ago, your ancestor and others will come back, since they need bodies from their own descendants. With an ancient practice known as metamorphosis of the soul, the will of your ancestor is going to take over your body. I don't know exactly what happens during this process, but the person you are now will be gone. You are nothing but a container for them. Your body will be their tool, and you'll be gone forever.
There are others like me.
Yes, there are others like you, but unlike you, they have all been conquered already, so we can't depend on any of them.
What is Nyarlathotep?
The crawling chaos, messenger of the gods. We definitely mustn't let them evoke him.
I've read in my grandfather's notes that you were in this house back then. Is this true?
Yes. The memories of that time came back to me faintly a few years ago, before my long journey. I dreamt about this house and your grandfather. But I couldn't understand the meaning of those dreams. I didn't remember anything about them. Yet, I dreamt almost every night. But more became clear when I was staying with the natives. There was something, some kind of incense they often used at night. It sweeps out the confusion and haze and makes your mind sharper. When you inhale it, you feel strange and remember a lot of long forgotten things, like the Pandora's box of your mind suddenly opening. That's when I remembered the times I stayed here, recalled why they locked me in this room, and what they gave me to make me calm. Those are memories I don't want to remember. And I'm glad I'll soon forget everything I went through. At least, I believe such a mercy exists in this universe.
What can we do to stop them?
Unfortunately, I am not completely sure. All sources on this subject are extremely secretive. All I know is that Nyarlathotep must be evoked before the rite. And there is an antique crystal stone used for this purpose. This was done in the same fashion centuries earlier. In any case, we must reach the buried city below us. There should be an entrance from this house. You must find it. Here, take this. This is part of an object that acts as a key. We need to complete it to reach the city.
Do you hear the sounds coming from within the walls?
No, I don't.
I see. So this damned house tries to speak to me alone.
I have to go now. I still have some things to do. We'll meet in the city. You absolutely must find the entrance and the other parts of the key.
I'll be on my way as well.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.